Hey, what is going on, everybody? It is your boy AK Myself here, back with some more Battlefield Hardline action for you guys today. In this gameplay, we're going to be making an aggressive withdrawal on Bang Child with no survivors in this gameplay. But before I get into today's gameplay and some tips for you guys, I want to talk a little bit about where I've been in regards to videos and basically where I went last weekend. Basically, I'll give you a rundown. I explained this in a previous video. I basically had a funeral to go to, and the funeral was for my grandmother, who lives all the way down in North Carolina, Charlotte, which is relatively far away, and I normally drive down there, but unfortunately it was so short notice that I did not have the mentality to drive down there. So I got a plane with me and my family, and we flew down there about last Thursday night. Yeah, about Thursday night. So we flew down there, and I scheduled videos for the weekend for you guys, and I got back around Monday evening, or Monday evening into Tuesday is when I got back. So overall, it was a good trip, but you know, I hope you guys did enjoy the videos that I put up. I do appreciate everybody who stayed active on my channel during my departing. I will try to schedule more videos, because I realize that it helps me stay ahead of schedule in regards to scheduling videos. I normally only schedule videos when I'm away, or I have stuff to do and I just don't have time to make a video, so I make videos ahead of time. But you know, all those videos scheduled out, it was actually a really good thing, so I'm glad I did it, and I do plan to do it a lot more. So right here, I decided to do a little bit of some pole dancing, so let's get into this gameplay. Now, the gun that I'm using is the Enforcer class with the SA... I don't even remember the name of this gun. SA-58, something like that. I can't remember. It has some weird name to it, but you guys can see it. It's in the Enforcer class. It's definitely one of the best guns in the entire game. It's a 3-hit kill at pretty much almost every range. It drops down to about a 4-hit kill at long range, but in this gameplay, I'm actually going toe-to-toe with my friend, Orgasmic. He's a really good friend of mine, an absolute Battlefield god at this game. Me and him go in this gameplay, and we decided we were having some trouble trying to get, as you see, I get tier 4 right there. We were having some trouble trying to get on the same team, so we were like, you know what, screw it. Let's just play against each other and see what happened as I kill him right there, which was kind of funny. Didn't even know where I was coming from. Unfortunate for him, he had his defibs out. Got caught with his pants down, but we were having some trouble getting on the same team, so we were like, we're just gonna play against each other for a few rounds and see what happens. And this is the game, one of the gameplays that I got. Now, first things first, unfortunately, we did not win this game because we had a lot of bad luck in this video. On my side, I played the objective to the max. I dropped about 17,000 score, and we still ended up losing this game with roughly 50 kills. And, you know, it just was not working out in my favor. And I believe they did have a commander helping them out as well. We had a commander as well, but unfortunately, what made us lose this game more than anything is the fact that my teammates could not hold our home base, basically our vault. And when you can't hold your vault, you're basically giving yourself a game over on your side of the team, because that is critical when it comes to winning games, and especially in Blood Money. You have to be able to hold your own spawn point inside of the vault, because if you can't do that, you can forget about even winning the game, because it does not matter how much cash you pick up. If your money's constantly getting stolen over and over and over, you're just gonna die over and over again, and you're just never gonna win a single game. So, as I pick off this corner camping bastard sitting in the corner. Now, this gun that I'm using, like I said, is a very powerful gun. If you guys have not tried it, I believe it is the SA... It's the 58 OSW. I'm actually looking at the video right now. I can finally see it because it's like blurred out and whatnot. But the attachments that I'm using are the heavy barrel, I believe. Either the muzzle brake or the heavy barrel. Either or, they're both very good attachments. I'm also using the standard red dot sight, as well as, what's that underbell? The vertical grip. Do not use the stubby grip, because that is only if you're standing still. And I'm sure majority of you strafe and shoot just like me. So you're going to want to use that vertical grip to get that extra boost of accuracy with your gun. And when you get that, this gun is an absolute laser. Now, when you first pick it up, like I said, I will explain this in a future video, that the battle rifles in this game, for some reason, when you first pick them up, they are absolutely trash. And when I mean trash, I mean worthless pieces of crap, dude. And the reason for that is just because they have no attachments on them. Now, like I said, I'm going to explain this all in a future video, but they're absolutely horrible. But just give it time, get the attachments unlocked, play on some close quarter maps if you have to, and you'll eventually get the all the attachments that you need for this gun to make it a viable weapon on the battlefield. Now, as you can see, I'm trying to play the objective right now, because I know that it's a really close game. We're barely winning right now. The score is roughly 98 to 97, and I know previously we were losing money in our vault earlier, so I know I have to stick to this area. Otherwise, we're gonna end up getting stolen vault again within our cache. And as you see, I pick up this cache. It's only two, but I decided, should I take the cache to the vault? Should I get more to help the scoreboard up? But I figured, well, let me deposit this two cache right now and hopefully get the scoreboard back to where it was. So I do deposit this, and if you stand by your cache deposit with another teammate, you actually do get assist points for that. So if you have a bunch of cash and you see a bunch of other guys coming with cash, just stick by the vault for roughly 2 to 5 seconds or so, or even 10 seconds, and just stay with them as they deposit that cash. And you see I deposit more cash, but it's not enough because our vault is still getting raided over and over. You see, I'm catching guys on the right hand side who are still coming from the right-hand side trying to take our vault, and that is costing us the game right now. It is absolutely demeaning the fact that I've deposited so much cash. I actually looked at the stats in this gameplay, and I deposited about, I deposited about 80 points worth of cash. That is more than half of the scoreboard, and it was practically worthless just because of the fact that our vault kept getting raided over and over again as I catch over Casmith off guard again. And it's not even like I was playing against remotely decent players in this game. The only decent player I was playing against was Zori Kazmik, who knows what he's doing. But he even said, he's like, I don't know how your team is losing right now. As you can see, there's more guys coming from this side. I managed to pick up two, and there was a huge load of cash on the ground right in front of me right there. But I get killed as there was roughly too many people in our spawn point, and plus a combination of bad aim, which actually costed us the game right there. As you can see, the guy in first place actually has 22,000 score. As you can see, I wasn't the only one playing objective. But that large group of bad players on my team actually cost us the game. But regardless, hope you guys enjoyed this gameplay. Hope you guys enjoyed this commentary as well. Let me know if you guys have had any bad experiences in Blood Money. Anyways, I got a future video coming up later with some more tips in the Battle Rifle class, or as we explore more in the Scar Rage. As you see, I tried to deposit all this cash, nearly died to my teammate blocking it. But we still was not enough as we lost the game. So close, 142-50 was the final score, I believe. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed this gameplay. It is your boy AK, signing out. Peace. Yeah, you saw the score go from 100.